Let's go!
Oh! gonna have a party.
Thank you.
play that cello.
I love you, Cory.
Starting a new tour and kicking a new tour off the ground is also the planning that goes into it. A lot of people hate the planning. I love the planning. I love being a part of the process, trying to build a show, build an evening for all of you to come and enjoy. And I know that most of you care a lot about music. That's why you're here. I do know that many of my fans are musicians or creatives themselves, so that is also why it is really important for me to make sure that the other musicians that come along with me, both on my team and whoever else happens to be special guests or opening the evening, is also equally compelling in what they do. Please give it up for Truesdale this evening.
Yeah! Woo! He's coming out!
And one of the things I get to do with collaborating is bring some of them out. USC.
I heard you out of this.
Oh, you did? Okay. A lot of my friends that I've started to meet over the last several years who are awesome musicians are from USC, and I don't know what they have going on there, but they seem to have a great program. I am not being paid by them to say this, nor are they. Just genuine fandom of whatever they have going on there. So, this is not my last record. This is called Crisis.
I'm in.
So like I said, building a show is something that is fun for me to do. So part of my job is I get to make tax write-offs by going to other concerts.
Yeah!
And seeing what other people are doing, seeing what works, seeing what's fun, seeing how other people are expressing their authentic self and what it is that's magnetic about them and how they connect with their audiences. And I went to a concert several months ago. It was a very interesting show at the Hollywood Bowl. It was Garbage, Alanis Morissette, Weezer, Halsey, wow, and OneRepublic. Quite amazing. I went there thinking, I know zero OneRepublic songs. I know who they are, but I don't know any of their songs. I left realizing that I know every OneRepublic song. Just like on commercials and on the radio everywhere. And there was one part in the set where Ryan Tedder, the band leader, said, oh yeah, you've heard all these songs everywhere, but guess what? I've also written a bunch of other songs. These are all ones that have been number one on the radio, that are on the radio right now. And he played a medley of about six or seven songs that were number one hits through the last year. And I thought, oh, that's a really interesting thing to do. I could do that. I could play songs that I've written that are number one songs over the last 6 months. We're gonna do that now, except I did not write any of these. None of them are currently number one on the radio. But they do have one thing in common, and they are near and dear to my heart because they are songs that have strong instrumental hooks, and they are also songs that remind me of my middle school dance.
Okay. Ready?
Thank you.
moment. Because a lot of this gear, it's a lot, okay? There's a lot of gear to bring on the road. And one of these days, I'm going to change how that looks just for one tour. Because we were flying around a lot, we were playing a lot of gigs. What ends up happening is you fly with a bunch of instruments and the airlines see you come and they're like, 12 people with all this gear, there's no way we're letting you on this plane like this. Not going to happen. You with the Barry Saxon, not a chance. You really think that's gonna get on board? They look at Sonny T coming in with that radioactive bass, they're like, not a chance. That thing ain't coming on board. They're swiping it with the little thing, putting it through their chemical tester. So we've decided that we're gonna do a band called Cherry-Ons Only. We're trying it out on this tour.
Tiny instruments.
So the only requirement for the next two songs is that everything must fit.
Yeah! No, he called you!
Guess what, Anthony? I'm back. I've been dodging your calls for the last 8 months.
Yeah!
Guitar picks, but I do need the smallest drum set you've got. Is that not the cutest thing you've ever seen? Sonny T, you got a little bass over there?
Thank you.
realize there's a couple parts that are going to be kind of hard. Cool.
Yeah.
Maybe I moved my chair. There's no way I moved this far.
Hey guys.
I don't hear it. Here we go.
my goodness.
I've waited about 18 years to be able to say that sentence.
Oh my gosh.
Here's our first show together.
Woohoo!
Yeah, baby. Absolute legend. Victor Wong.
Yeah! Yeah! Woo! Yeah, baby.
Thank you.
copy of Your Perfect Morning. I was trying to teach me. I was like, dude, you gotta show me. I was like, no, 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 you don't want to do that.
Thank you.
They look like they're thinking so hard. And now I know why. It's a lot of counting. A lot of time feels. Sonny, you gonna come play some acoustic?
We still love you!
One of my favorite bands in the entire world is Bela Fleck and the Flecktones. I watched Victor play when I was a teenager. They came to the Minnesota Zoo.
Wow.
Which you would think, like, wait, what? There's an amphitheater at the zoo. And it's actually a really nice setting, outdoor amphitheater. I was a teenager, very, very formative point in my life. I was trying to figure out, is music a thing that's possible to do? And also, like, kind of rhythm guitar, somewhat lead guitar guy, and could I do that as a band leader? Like, what if I want to have horns and all this other stuff? And I was going on all these different ways of trying to do things, and I was thinking and very insecure about, I love jazz, I love punk rock, I love funk, I love all the pop music, all these different types of music. Is it even possible to do all this sort of thing with all these different genres? Are people gonna care? Are people gonna come? And when I saw Bela Fleck and the Flecktones, and I saw Victor play Amazing Grace.
Oh my gosh.
It was something that felt like, it was a moment that really gave me permission to be able to do what I do. So it is such a treat to be here in front of you, and it is an absolute joy and gift to be able to have Victor Wooten with us. So.
Thank you.
trumpet man, Jim Webb.
Yeah, boy.
Back there, that's Michael Nelson on the
trumpet. Yeah, Michael!
Thank you so much for coming this evening. Good evening, St. Louis. My name is Cory Wong. I'm here to talk about tonight's performances, all the wins, all the losses. I'm here to take ownership for anything that happened with my team. I'm here to address any mistakes that were made on the stage. It's the first night of the tour. Of the press here this evening. We're here to field questions. No holds barred. I'm willing to answer anything. You can address specific members of the band. You can address Vic. You can address Truesdale. And and we'll decide whether we answer those questions or not. Here's how it's going to work. My tour manager, Cory is right down here in the front. He's got a microphone. Please raise your hand, state your name, the publication you're with. Come at me with your questions, no hold barred. Let's rock. Who's up first? Right down here in the front, the glasses. You're wearing the merch, so somehow you get called on.
From the city of Wildwood, Missouri. My question is for the architect and Cory. What is your favorite drum rudiment?
My favorite drum rudiment?
Yes.
I was always a big fan of the Swiss triplet.
A rat-a-macule.
That is a real one, yeah.
Yeah.
We have Relics magazine right here.
Hey, my name's Jack. Love the mini, the carry-on concert. Are you working with Fender to make a travel-size signature guitar?
We're working on a handful of prototypes right now. There's some fun projects in the works. We got a great A&R team over at Fender. I'm glad to be there. I signed on with Fender about 4 years ago. Unfortunately, fourth round in the draft, but it took a few years to get there. We got the signature guitar. I've been putting up some good numbers for them over the last 2 years since the signature guitar came a concept, released in July of 21. We're working on some other concepts. I think the carry-on's only thing is bound to happen. Thank you for your question. Next, right there in the front with the papers. Yeah. I served.
Uh-oh.
Hey, what's up, bro?
Just got done doing a concert. What's happening?
Not much, bro. So, I have a test tomorrow in Theory 3.
Can I get your sax?
It's in non-chord tones.
Yeah.
And I'm just wondering, do you mind signing my homework?
Yeah. Mozart Piano Sonata in D. Sorry, in G. Is this Theory 2?
Yeah.
Oh, Theory 3. Would be Theory 2 for us.
Oh! He's going down. What's going on?
I don't know. I didn't want me to sign his homework. He's trying to get out of school.
Woo!
So we need to come to UM, all right? Next question, right down here, Downbeat Magazine.
Hi, I'm Cameron. What was your favorite moment from tonight?
Did somebody say trombone solo?
Yeah! Wow!
My favorite moment from tonight's show was backstage before we played when all of us got to circle up and express gratitude towards each other for this tour.
Expect on the next year's podcast, the next season's
podcast.
Who?
There's a handful of guests that are watching, waiting, commiserating.
Oh.
There is some guests who are shredders. The person giggling is the only one who got it. I'm glad that you got it. I'm glad. Thank you. The majority of you don't understand what I said, but I'm glad that it landed. It was worth it. I thought it was pretty quick myself. There's some shredders, there's some bass players, there's some songwriters. We got some good stuff coming to the podcast. Let's get Truesdale on the podcast.
Okay.
I'll take two more questions. Two more questions right down here in the front.
Hello, my name is Reiko, and actually we have seen some phenomenal collaborations. Do we see a Cory Wong Truesdale collab coming in the future?
I said I wanted to, but they're busy working on their own album right now. When they're done, I want them to work on their record, finish their thing, and then I want to do something together. If you guys are down, let's do it. All
right.
No more dodging my emails. No, they respond nicely. One more question, right down here in the front. Blue. Rolling Stone magazine, thanks for being here.
My name is Roger from the Roger Garage and the Funky Bunch.
Okay.
Nice.
My question is, Victor, I don't know if you promised, but I feel like you promised Dean Town. And I want Dean Town. Please and thank you.
Under the bus so hard. It's important for an artist to understand his limitations and sometimes just allow yourself and your ego to die, to go away. And the strongest act of that on a stage in my entire life is I'm going to play Dean Town along with two of the greatest bass.
What? On the mini?
Then the straps on the other side just being for study.